Hey guys, this is David Kwan. Xbox One was revealed yesterday, and so I just thought I might as well jump in on the bandwagon and join in with millions of other YouTubers making videos on this topic and sharing their opinions. So these are my thoughts on Xbox One and the reveal. First off, I think it's a pretty cool piece of technology. There's a lot of really neat features, and the technology looks really sophisticated. Especially how far if what they're saying is true, because a lot of it does seem to be smoke and mirrors. But if what they're saying is true about Kinect, for example, it looks like a really advanced piece of technology. It could detect, it can even be used in total darkness because it has infrared sensors and night vision. Really awesome stuff, and I think Microsoft is really smart and with these features because it has a chance of becoming really big with mainstream American public, and I had to specifically categorize that because I think that's also part of the problem with this console, is that it's so U.S. centric, and you know I think it has a really big, it's going to be a big hit with the American public, because American, you know, the football and basketball lovers, sports lovers, being able to watch TV and interact with the TV, these are all great ideas, but it feels like none of these services are going to be available at launch in other countries. Australia, Japan, United Kingdom, the African countries, definitely not going to be available at launch. So it has a very US, this console is so focused on the American market, and it's going to do well in the American market. I don't have any doubts that it's going to be really successful, knowing the marketing power and marketing genius of Microsoft. But if the 360 is any indication, the rest of the world is not going to be very enthused about Xbox One, because none of these services, none of these features are going to be available at launch, and who knows how long it's going to take them for actually do anything for the other countries. I know for, you know, Japan is not going to adopt this console for a long time. I mean, just considering the size of this console is huge. It looks as big or bigger than like your typical desktop PC tower. And just you put it just horizontally and it's that big. It's pretty ridiculous. Big size is a really negative thing to me. I always thought my original fat PS3, 60GB PS3 was a gigantic pain in the ass. Especially when I'm taking it to my parents' home, who live in a different state like Tennessee or California, and I live in New York, and having it go through the airport security system, and the system is so heavy, such a pain in the ass to, you know, to move to a different location. And I feel like Xbox One is even bigger than the PS3, which is ridiculous. So definitely not a big fan of that, but I guess It makes sense because of all the powers packing. I don't know. So really, that's those are pretty much my general thoughts about the console and the reveal. I really don't have much right to talk about Xbox One because I'm not the intended target audience. None of what was said in the Xbox reveal, I don't care about any of that. I don't use TV like that. I don't really follow sports. I used to really like to follow soccer and World Cup and such, but don't really do that anymore. It's the focus that the Microsoft revealed, I don't care about it. And it seems like the more I learn about it, the more I'm turned off, because there's so many things that are still not clarified as they should be clarified about being able to use games. There's complications with that. There's complications with having to update your 360 every single day in order to use games that you bought and you access. There's something about mandatory installs, how cloud gaming would work, even though it's just mentioned, oh, it's a cloud-powered system. Like, okay, you just threw that jingle around expecting people would be excited, but what do you actually mean by that? There's so many things that are just not clarified with the Xbox One, and the more I learn about it, the less I'm enthused. I mean, I've never even owned an Xbox 360 in my life, so I'm obviously never been a target audience for Microsoft. Never have been. I did enjoy a couple of Xbox 360 games by playing it on my friend's Xbox 360, but I've never owned it. So obviously this video is, this is it. You know, I don't have too many excitement over Xbox One, but to be fair, I don't really have excitement over it, the other next generation consoles either. The other next generation console being a PS4, I think that looks pretty cool. That's more my ball game, but pricing is going to be a big hurdle, because I think that thing is going to be super expensive. And neither Xbox One or PS4 is backwards compatible with their older games, PS3 games and 360 games. So I don't care. They're not backwards compatible. I'd rather spend $100 to fix my PS3 and get that running than buy a PS4, honestly, because my PS3 library is pretty damn huge. So if I have extra $100, that's what I'm going to do. If I have extra $500 to spend on a new console, I'm not going to buy Xbox One. I'm not going to buy a PS4. And forget the Wii U. That's not going to happen ever. I'm probably just going to buy a medium-range desktop PC and go with the PC gaming route, because that seems to be the best option available when you consider the next-generation consoles. Those are my thoughts. Share your thoughts about what you thought about Xbox One. Any comments would be really appreciated. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.